Welcome back to season two of DJs is EJs with Pioneer DJ USA. My name is Ryan Roth, aka Roy LaCroix. For those who are new, DJs and PJs season two is twice a month on Thursdays at 4 p.m. PT. And we're back today. So we feature a live DJ performance and question and answer from artists in their natural habitat, typically rocking pajamas. So today we've got Grammy nominated electronic artist Wuki, currently living in Denver but born in New Jersey. Chris Barman is known for his multi-genre tunes, jumping between booty, breaks, electro, and house. He got started with music professionally in 2007 with his electronic rock band Inner Party System. You may recognize his recent releases as Wuki on imprints such as Ausla, Main Course, Mad Decent, Fool's Gold, and Ultra Records. The list just goes on and on. Currently, he is working on streaming a ton on Twitch and cranking out new tunes. Also, go check out his new track with Young Baby Tate and Stoppa called Hey Ladies, and that is streaming everywhere right now. So, Wuki is rocking a 45-minute set on the new CDJ-3000s and DJM-V10. Afterwards, he'll be answering your questions about anything from production, life, DJing, dogs, whatever it may be. Drop those questions in the Twitch comments and he'll try to get to the best ones. So, all right. Everyone, thank you guys so much for tuning in here to DJs and PJs. Go ahead and drop some fire emotes in the comments section. Follow us on Twitch. Follow Wuki on Twitch. And without any further delay, make some noise for the dude Wuki. Here we go.
Yo, yo, thanks for the intro, man. How's everyone doing? Thanks for having me. My name is Wuki. Let's get going. Let's do this. Blessed to have these CDJs. They're so nice. If you guys have any questions, I see your comments. Feel free to ask me anything. Wants the funk? Let me know in the chat if you like the funk. Yeah. What's up, everyone in the chat? I see you. Let me know where you're from. LA in the house. New Jersey, Boston, SoCal, Santa Maria. What up, Sticky? What up, Sassy? Make it. Do it. Makes us. Harder, better, faster, stronger. More than power, power, never. I wanna be on Mars right now, not gonna lie. UK in the house, what up? New Wuki shit right here. I've been making a lot of stupid stuff during quarantine. I'm gonna play some of it. That's cool to you guys. New Jersey. I was born in Jersey. Jersey bros unite. Yo, we're the classic rock heads in the house. Let me know. Hope you guys don't mind if we turn the F up right now. Big tune from my boy Martin Horger.
To another dimension. I need it.
who just saw me hit my head on the mic. Go to Funky Town. How do I access these edits? Come to my stream. I give these out to my subscribers. I'm always making new ones on stream. I'm always DJing them, so please come through.
Break it, fix it, crash it, change it, melt, upgrade it, charge it, point it, zoom it, press it, snap it, work
Yo, make some noise if you heard this on TikTok. Shout out Roxana on the vocals. That's my girl. Shout out Valentino Khan. Alright, how many people want me to do the dance? I'll let the second drop go and we'll do the dance. I want to see you guys doing at home though. If you're listening, tag me on Instagram, Twitter, whatever. I'll do the dance, but you guys gotta come through to my Twitch in an hour. Bitches, I'm the better bitch. Link all these other bitches. So fuck the other bitches. Cause I'm the best bitch. I'm the better bitch. Link all these other bitches. So fuck the other bitches. Cause I'm the best bitch. So fuck the other bitches. Fuck the other bitches. Fuck the other bitches. Bitches. No lie, I kind of forget it. Here we go. No, bitches. I'm not a dancer. No, bitches. I miss EDM. Just wait for it. I promise it's worth it.
right. Like the way he's speaking, his confidence is peaking. Don't like his baggy jeans, but I like what's underneath it. And no, I ain't been to MIA. I heard the county never went to New York.
Yes, on the brand new 3000s right here. We're in the future.
I'm liking this American boy, American boy. Take me on a trip, I'd love to go someday. Take me to New York, I'd love to see LA. I really want to come pick you up with you.
Also, I never use this mixer, but it's crazy. It like, it has like a sound to it. I don't know how to put it into words. We can talk about it later.
Tell them where to put it, never tell them where I'm about to be. I run down on them before I have a nigga running me. Talk your shit, bite your lip, ask for a call while you ride that dick. You really ain't never got him fucking for a thing. He already made his mind up before he came. Now fuck this ass pussy, fuck this ass pussy. I'm a phone just for pictures. Fuck this ass pussy.
Tycho Bay.
Your hands, if you got that shit, light it up. And while you're up, everybody go
back
to a place where you've been before. Old school to the new, it's time to go
four
to a whole new level. A little more bass and a little more treble.
Back,
cause motherfuckers don't understand. Mr. V got the mic in his hands, so go
four,
cause we on course. Better yet, on track, like a jockey to a horse. Move.
Yo, bonus points for whoever knows who this is.
Back. four.
Eddie LeGrand is right, Roy LaCroix. Jeff, you never got bonus points. It's all right, man. Dude, I'm loving the 3Ks. I'm feeling so honored I get to use these before they're really out in the wild.
Pump that in.
the play cue buttons feel in comparison? Honestly, it's the same classic feel, to be honest. Which I'm happy about. Yeah, I don't know if we'll touch on it on the interview, but one of my favorite parts is how well the time warping sounds now. Check this out. I'm just doing this to show you guys how good it sounds. So you can go all the way down to 0.6. Like, there's actually some really cool potential for sound design if you had these in the studio. All right, sorry. Yo, not gonna lie, the filters on the V10 fucked me up. How we feeling in the chat? What are you guys up to? Only got a few more if I'm correct. What do you guys want to know about these DJs? Oh yeah, another one of my favorite features. I don't know if you guys can see it, but if you have the artwork synced up to your tracks, it shows up on the platter, which, I don't know, I just nerd out. I love that, and it actually makes me want to like really go through my iTunes and make sure, or record box, and make sure all the artwork is there. Yes, it's still on, Sticky. Come through. Yeah. Yeah, it looks like we're going a little late. Shouldn't go later than 15 minutes. All right, yeah, let's do it. Let's go. Thank you, guys. Hopefully it wasn't too rough. Brand new on these CDJs. Only been using them for like a day.
Yo, yo, yo.
Yo, what's up, bro?
What's up, brother? Dude, nice set.
Oh, thank you, man. It's easy with this amazing gear.
Bro, how'd you like it? How do you like spinning on those things?
I love it, man. It's pretty easy to get used to. I mean, obviously the touch screen and like interface is like incredible now. It's so easy. Actually, one feature that is amazing is the search feature now is so nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Search feature is great. Dude, those screens are so big too.
Hell yeah. Yeah. You see everything. Just search Wuki. It has like every track I've ever made. Super dope.
Oh, heck yeah, man. Well, dude, thanks for jumping on. Thanks to everybody in the comments on Facebook, on Twitch, everyone who's watching right now, everyone who's engaging. Make some noise for the dude Wuki. He absolutely just killed it. Let's see some fire emojis. Let's see some Bob Ross emojis, whatever you guys got. Throw it up there. So my name is Ryan Roth. I'm going to be running the Q&A here for Wuki and DJs and PJs. And then afterwards, we're going to be rating his Wuki and Friends Twitch channel.
GTA. So GTA's there waiting.
Yeah. Oh, GTA's over there right now, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, nice, man. Okay. Okay. So yeah, that'll be exciting. So let's get through a few questions here. So first off, there's a few things I wanted to ask you. I was just kind of watching your stream. What's up with the world map behind you? Did you study geography, or is that, you know, perhaps where you've traveled? Or
okay, full disclosure, actually the real reason is because there's like this ugly thing on the wall up here that was in the house when I bought it. And the basement's the only thing I haven't remodeled. That's why you see like this ugly red wall and stuff. So there's like this weird like boxy thing just hanging on the wall. So I was like, I need something to cover it. And I didn't want to like redo the wall and everything. So I was like, I'm just going to get a poster. I think it's kind of cool and just deal with it for now. And then I'll fix it later.
Dude, that's hilarious. I love the brutal honesty.
Yeah, but that is the reason.
Yeah, I mean, I was thinking over here at PD Pioneer DJ, we were thinking maybe that's like everywhere you've toured and you pin on all, you know, all over the world. And
I mean, that sounds cool, but unfortunately, I'm not that cool. But maybe one day I'll be that cool.
So let's talk a little bit here about the CDJs and that V10, man. You were kind of briefly touching a little bit in the comments on like, you know, how you like them and things like that. But like, what are some of your like top favorite things that you've noticed that really like stick out to you about using the 3000s?
So yeah, I wrote down a couple things, but I know right off the bat, I love the I love the search feature. Like, it's so nice, and obviously just like the interface in general is so nice now. It's like stupid easy to go through and find stuff. Also the touch screen, like if you want to just search by key, you just touch key and it sorts them all, which is awesome. Also the key sync stuff, I was playing around with it yesterday, is really cool. I own a DJM-800, and one of my favorite features on that was the transpose knob.
Okay.
So now that is back basically internally in the CDJ, that's pretty cool. I used to like to mess around with that. And then also just like the warping, I was saying it during the stream, but like I was messing around last night and I was just playing something kind of ambient and warping it all the way to 0.6%. And then putting with the effects on and the filter, and like it's actually a really powerful sound design tool. So I thought that was really cool too.
Dude, the warping is really, really great. I mean, honestly, I think that the Nexus 2 series CDJs had a really good sound quality, but the 3000s are just like even better. I mean, even we had Cascade on the show a few weeks ago, and he was like, he was telling our product planning guy, he was like, yo, the first thing I noticed was how clean these CDJs sound. He was like, are they better? Like, are, you know, there's something different.
Yeah, it really is noticeably different. Like, it sounds so good. Even if you just want to speed a track up like 10 BPM, it's so easy and clean and sounds great.
For sure. I also really like the, like you were saying, the pitch adjustment so that you can actually like match keys a little easier. We definitely like, you know, we're really really happy about that.
Yeah.
And the eight hot cues, having the eight hot cues there for me, I love like maximizing all the hot cues on my.
See, on my I need tracks. To do that. I've always just done the call, the, like the
arrow, the memory cues.
The memory. I always just do that, but I'm realizing how powerful these could be now. Because they're like, I realize, yeah, I mean, I always knew how powerful they were in the other ones, but now I'm realizing I have eight. So it's like, oh shit, I better get on top of that. And oh, the slip mode is also very cool. So if something's playing, you could, it always stays on beat.
Yeah, it's a nice effect.
Yeah, that's super cool.
Go ahead.
I was going to say, another thing is the CDJ mode. The other CDJs didn't do this, right? Like, if you hit play, it just, like, it, like, stutters it.
You know, I think it did. Like, if you turn on did? CDJ versus vinyl mode, yeah, I'm pretty sure that older CDJs do that.
Maybe not mine, because they're super old, but...
Yeah. it might be like a CDJ like emergency thing or something. I'm not 100% sure on that, but I think I've seen that feature before. The one I really like though is you have your 4 and 8 hot cue, or I mean loopers right there. So you got quantize on, you can just automatically just hit 8, and you can like ride that if it's like a house track, you can ride it forever.
Yeah, that works super well. I did that a couple times during the set, and then another thing is the beat jump. If it if you're, you know, if you want to like, how do I explain it? It basically, like, you could jump measures and it stays in beat. That's really cool. Like, if you want to check the end of a song, or if you want to extend a measure like on the fly, that's really easy to do. So that's cool.
What about the V10?
The V10 is crazy. This thing's a beast. though, I guess the one thing that took a little getting used to was the different. Filter like I'm so used to the DJM 800 or 900 where you have one knob that goes from high pass to low pass. So this, I don't know if you guys could see, but basically you pick low pass or high pass, and then one knob does each one. So it was like I'm just so used to the other way that like the took me a sec to get used to that. I messed up a couple times in a set, but whatever.
Dude, whatever. You know what? The first time I played on those, I had the exact same adjustment period where I was like, oh, the filter has to go from 0 to 100, not from in the middle, -100 to +100 or whatever. It was definitely a little adjustment, but once you get used to it, they're butter.
No, yeah, this thing is amazing. The auto tap for the effects is really helpful. Instead of like switching which track you want the effect on, now you just hit a beat assign button, which is really nice, or effect assign. And then also just the sound of this mixer. I think I said it earlier, but it just like, I don't know, something happens to the audio. It has like a built-in something. It puts it together. I don't know. It sounds really good.
There's a little compressor knob at the top too to add a little bit of warmth to it, and that was kind of what we were sort of going for when we designed it. You know, was created a mixer that had that vibe like the Nexus 2, but you know, almost gave it a little more of like a warmer sound. You know, I'm not an engineer, but I imagine all the engineers knew what they were doing.
No, yeah, I was playing with that. I actually have it jacked up for my sampler because it's a. This is a velocity controlled, so I have it jacked up, I could. It's all the same, pretty much.
And you got the, I think you said you were using a co-oscillator too, you're running that through?
Yeah, K-oscillator. So yeah, I'm using four of the channels. I have two other CDJs. I just didn't have the space to set them all up. So
yeah,
one day.
For sure. One day. One day. So I want to kind of get into a little bit about your life quickly. You know, talk to us about, you know, some of your, you know, greatest accomplishments. What was it like to be nominated for a Grammy? What was that feeling like?
Oh, man. I mean, it was amazing. Not to sound cliche, but it was like, you know, it's probably one of the highlights of my life up until now. It's like a big stamp of approval on my career. I think I like kind of always doubt myself, and I always like, am I doing the right thing? Am I in the right direction? So that was just like, it was basically the universe telling me like, yo, you made some good choices, man. Just keep going. So,
for sure.
I mean, yeah, I mean, it's awesome. I don't even know how to say it without sounding corny. It's really, really validating. It sounds great. It was so fun to be able to go. And yeah, I'm just very grateful that I have that. Yeah.
It's a sick remix, man. I mean, how is it working with Miley?
Well, I didn't work with her, but working with her team was amazing. I mean, that's actually the fastest I ever got paid for a remix. Like,
oh yeah.
Everything. Like the whole, like it all happened within a month. They wanted the remix. I got it done. They approved it and they put it out and paid me like all within a month, which is like unfucking heard of in the music industry.
Wow. So you cranked that remix out. I mean, like you went to work and you're like, yo, I'm locking myself in my room, getting this thing done.
Yeah, for sure. Actually, I recently changed management like last year, and that was one of the first things that they brought in, basically first opportunities. So, awesome. I mean, not that I don't always want to crush it, but like I especially wanted to crush it because it's like, all right, this is the first thing my new team's bringing in, time to go 100%. And yeah, it was turned out to be a home run. Hell yeah.
Nice, man. Nice. So what was the, I guess, transition between Inner Party System and the brand Wuki? For many of you guys out there, I'm not sure if you know, but Chris actually was in a band called Inner Party System, did kind of electronic rock. So what was it like kind of rebranding to Wuki and kind of going over to that more electronic and DJ side of the music industry?
So I was getting like into dance music during the Inner Party System days. We would do after parties and stuff like that. That's kind of when I started learning DJing. I used to DJ just on Ableton, like with an MPC or like a controller in Ableton.
Sure.
And then I realized you could just roll up with a USB stick and use the amazing CDJs. So I was like, all right, I got to learn these. And basically kept going. The band stopped. I had a good year of like transition where I basically had to restart, send my music out everywhere, restart basically from scratch, new project. And yeah, I mean, it was tough to restart. That was a really hard year, but I don't know. Just keep pushing, man. That's it. You just got to keep going. Just keep going. That's it.
That's great advice, man. That's great advice. So yeah. You kind of, how did you settle on, you know, in your bio, you have, you know, a lot of different genres that you work on. And so kind of coming from electronic rock and going into like booty and house and, you know, all sorts of different genres. Kind of what's your mission behind your project?
Well, I mean, honestly, I have been kind of all over the place. Maybe like Wuki isn't the most like focused project as like, you know, someone like, I don't know, Joyride, or it's like, you know exactly what you're going to get. Like everything is like super dark and minimal and crazy and cool. I've always been kind of like a multi-genre producer. I make whatever I want. The common thread between my stuff is like, it tends to be more fun, less serious. Mm-hmm. And obviously a lot of my edits, I do a lot of like stupid, funny edits. I've been remixing really stupid shit on my Twitch. Like I remixed Mr. Sandman.
Yeah, I saw that. That was hilarious, dude. But it sounded dope too, you know? Like,
I guess that's what I try to do. I try to take something that would be kind of stupid and like turn it into something that's kind of dope and you could party to, I guess.
I dig it, man. And that's kind of how WikiLeaks started and how you kind of started putting out other edits and stuff like that.
Yeah, exactly. I basically would make these for live shows all the time and be like I knew from like 5 years ago I wasn't the best sound designer in the world. That wasn't going to be my route. my route was like taking my knowledge and like my sense of humor and my personality and like try and wrap it all into like a dope live show. And nice. So I started making these like funny edits that would like trick people kind of in at clubs. And then it kind of one thing led to another and like da 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 got huge. We like the fuck this shit got huge.
Yeah.
And so I was like, all right, let's just go. Let's fucking go with Wookie Leaks. Let's go.
Love it, man. Love it. Yeah, you kind of do have to trick people when you're performing live because people sometimes they come to the club a little closed-minded where they just want to hear, you know, the top five songs on the radio right now. And you got to be like, hey, yo, yeah, but what if I added this spin to it? Would you still like it? You know?
No, yeah, that's exactly right. And I don't know. I think there's more than one way to make a crowd go, oh, other than, you know, just like the biggest, fattest bass drop ever. Like you could make people have fun without that.
And yeah, so someone in the comments says they like to be surprised. You know, some people do like to be surprised.
Me too. I mean, when I go see a DJ, hopefully we can soon, but I'm always looking for like those kind of like creative ways that they're playing tracks instead of just mixing one and the other or whatever.
100%. So let's kind of dive into some of the Twitch comments real quick. I know you've got a stream to get to. We don't want to keep GTA waiting for too long.
It's all good.
But so we had a few comments in here, and the first one was GregJ805. What's a good place to get music to play for your live streams? So he's kind of, I guess this is more of like a licensing and rights question.
Oh, because live streams are getting like canceled and stuff, like blocked out and stuff.
So maybe what's your take on that?
You know, I just saw yesterday there was a big announcement, like 20 different labels that are coming together to approve for Twitch. So that, I would just go look at that tweet and find that information. Other than that, like, dude, SoundCloud, I think SoundCloud is on that, but like, I mean, that kind of stuff, like more, like underground stuff isn't going to get flagged just because it's not huge. So, yeah. I mean, that is one way. Obviously, one thing, like if you do like pop remixes, those will probably get flagged. But I don't know. I also like trying to get on promos like before things go up on Spotify and stuff. Mm. So that way you got a good 2 weeks before anything will get down.
Yeah. So get on those in-flight and your army promo lists.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
No, that's great advice. And actually, I'm really excited about the Twitch thing with, I don't know, like Monster Cat and like some other really big labels are participating.
Yeah, Insomniac is doing it too.
Insomniac's on there too, which is amazing. So hopefully this is kind of a trend that we start to see more and more of.
Yeah, definitely. I think it should.
Yeah, it should. So next question, Subaru Family Adventures, which is our man Hector. What road bike is that? And how many miles do you average per ride?
Oh, shit. This is a BH. It's like a custom one from Spain, apparently. I bought it used.
Oh, fancy.
But I just got it a couple months ago because I just moved back to Colorado. And I was like, I got to get a sick road bike. And they're so hard to find. So I had to get one used. But I friggin' love this thing. It's only like 15 pounds. It's so fast. And I average probably right now 20 to 25 miles.
Okay. That's solid.
I'm working my way up. I'm getting back into it.
Dude, Tour de France coming soon.
Yeah. Actually, didn't Benny Benassi do a bike tour? Like he toured the Pacific Northwest on his bike or something like that, I think.
You know, I didn't hear about that, but that is absolutely something he would do.
I think he did.
That sounds awesome. Couple more questions here for you. Well, you might have touched on this, but again, how do I get access to those edits? They're gold from Pandemonium 609.
So yeah, if you guys want my edits and you want to basically be in the know with the Wookie music, come join my Discord, hang out on my Twitch. I make music on there. I give out edits. I give out little Ableton packs. I give out samples. So yeah, basically join my Discord. Come hang on my Twitch later And yeah, just you'll get them. If you want them, you could get them. Just got to come hang out.
That sounds like a famous song.
Yeah.
I think so what was the Funky Town edit and technologic edit? Were those yours?
The Funky Town one was done by Acraze, and the Technologic one was me and Shipwreck.
Nice, because that those two really stuck out to me. I was like, yo, what? Like, this is nuts.
Thank you. I'll send them to you.
Yes, please. I'll holler at you afterwards for sure.
Hell yeah.
Cool. Well, anything else you want to plug? Any other, you know, projects you got upcoming? I heard you maybe be working on an album. Anything you want to talk about?
Yeah, just my album's coming out very soon. I've been releasing some singles along the way, and yeah, let's just keep grinding. Let's get through this year. I think we're getting close to the end, and I'm ready for it.
Heck yeah, man! Love the positivity, and I honestly keep doing the amazing work. Keep making music, and thank you for coming on our show. This has been an absolute blast.
Of course, man. Thank you so much for having me. Thanks for gracing me with these beautiful pieces of gear.
You're very, very welcome. So for everyone in the Twitch and Facebook section, we're going to be headed over to Wookie's channel here in the next minute. We'll be raiding him. But in the meantime, our schedule for DJs and PJs is October 15th, Jay Espinoza. We'll be performing on our Twitch and Facebook channel, Turntableist Guy, and we've got a very special announcement. Yo, what up, Carson? What's up? So it's going to be a really big one, so you guys make sure you come October 15th for that. That'll be exciting. And also go follow Wookie World on Twitch. Follow him on Facebook, social medias everywhere, and follow us on Twitch too, and stay in touch. All right, guys. Well, it's been real. We're going to head on over to Wookie's channel.
Let's go.